Hey, what's everybody? So in front of you, we have Peak Design's new micro clutch. We have the I plate and the L plate. So the I plate is more for cameras that don't have a grip, whereas with the L plate is for those who have a more pronounced grip, such as a mirrorless camera. So we're gonna give you a full unboxing of it, a quick overview, and some installation on how to set this up on your cameras. So let's go ahead, we start with the I plate. Move the L plate version to the side. So with the I plate, you get your I plate. Here is the strap that where your fingers would go into. Rubber padding. You have your anchor point. And you also have your special tool right here. So if you press in this little grooved area, extends out, and it is magnetic. And here is your tool. So this helps you tighten the screws. Here is your tripod plate. So this sits on here. So you can see it has this little groove right there that will match up with this groove right there. And it sits like that, and it is magnetic as well. So it does move, and you cannot get it out unless it's all the way at the end and it is removable. So there is like a little track inside, and there are little indicators that tells you the max area where this line can go or your screws. And included are two screws. So the short screw, which I'll go ahead and pop out, is if you're using just the plate only. So you'll screw this into the bottom of your camera. Once it's screwed in, you'll put the plate on and you'll slide it. So these indicators right here is pretty much the furthest you can go before it gets to the very end hole, and that's where the plate will come right out, as you can see. This long screw is for when you're using the tripod plate. When it's in there, obviously, small screw is not going to be big enough to fit. As you can see, it's not sliding in. So here, long screw has more of a spacing, so you can go ahead, put it in, and now it's able to slide freely to wherever your camera is located. Let's go ahead and put these back first. So also in the box is your card that tells you to read this first. Also talks about their lifetime warranty on all their products. You have your instruction booklet, tells you everything that's included. So you have your eye plate, your tool, your tripod plate, long and short fastener. You have your split ring tool, your split ring sleeve, and your split ring. So these three items here are inside here. There you go. So these are if you have a camera that has an eyelet, so it has like a little round ring on there, such as Nikon cameras. I'm not sure about Sony, but I know Canon does not. So these would not be suitable for majority of Canon cameras unless it's like an EOS M or something like that. So this here are for more of those that has a round eyelet and you need a D-ring. So this is the eye plate. Let's go ahead and open up the L plate. So again, you get the same thing. You get your card about warranty, your instruction booklet, and your split ring adapters and whatnot. You get your same short screw, long screw, tripod plate. But as you can see, this is the L plate, L versus I. So again, this is suitable for those who that has a more pronounced grip on the camera. And again, you still get your tool that pops out. Your little eyelet for your anchor links. And this strap here swivels to the side, to the front, depending on your camera. So let's take a look and see how these are installed. And for the both of them, they're fairly the same. So you start off, install the small screw, put your plate over the screw, which is the main big hole, slide it, use the integrated flat tool to tighten the screw down slightly, and you make your adjustments. Here's the information on how to install the split rings. Again, here is a close-up of the type of split rings. So if you don't have these type of split rings where they're small, where you can't really fit these through the eyelet, that's where the split rings come in. Here's another view of it. And then once it's installed, that's where you slip this through the eyelet and then adjust the strap to its desired length, and then you attach it to what they call the keeper stud. So you just go ahead and just slip it right over it and it's locked in place. Any excess, you'll just tuck it inside this sleeve here. So again, you can put your ankle link in that little hole on the plate. And it tells you how to install onto tripod plate. So again, you use a long screw and attach. And the process is the same. And if you need to change out your battery or memory card, if it is at the bottom, all you have to do is just loosen up the screw, slide the plate off so that it's dangling, and this way it gives you access to your memory card or battery. So let's go ahead and install this onto a Canon camera. So here I have my Canon EOS R6. I'm going to show you how to use, well, what it looks like on an L with the eye plate. Unfortunately, it doesn't fit because of the size. Obviously, with a smaller camera, this will have no problem, but simply take the small screw, screw it in slightly, just enough that the plate can slide in. And if it doesn't, just loosen it just a little, slide it over, and now it's in there. And all you have to simply do is take the tool, tighten it down, and then just take this leather strap and either loop it through the eyelet that's on the camera or using the D-ring and just looping it through and attaching. But as you can see, even I've already tried with adjustments, and because of the size, this strap is not long enough. So if you want the eye plate, doesn't really fit well with Canon cameras that has an L grip. So with that, let's go ahead and install the L grip version. So just go ahead, loosen it, put it to the side. Here is the L version. And this does also come again with the tool here, but since I already have it from the eye, I'll just use that. Slide it in, make your adjustments. So I have it here lined up with the battery grip, as you can see, with the battery door, but as you can see, it's covered. So if I do want to change out the battery, I have to unloosen it, unloosen the screw, and either rotate it if I wanted to, but again, that won't be possible due to this strap being attached to the eyelet. So only other option is to completely slide it off where it's dangling. So let's go ahead and just install it so you can get a better visual. So there you go. It's on. This does swivel. It only comes up to here. I wish it went a little bit further because now it's kind of offset. Just loop it through. And as you can see with the L, I'm able to fit it through. So if you're familiar with Peak Designs backpacks, this is similar to what they have on their zippers. So with the R6, I pretty much have it on the first slot. So now you can see it's locked in. Here it is installed. And here it is with two fingers. I can fit three. I can access the buttons, shutter. So with three fingers, I'm 5'9", Asian hands, I can fit three. Obviously, depending on your size and how big your hands are, you might be able to fit two. But I think two is a little bit more comfortable for me because I can move my hands up or down, whereas with three, I'm limited and it feels a little tight. So with two, I can hold it. I can put a little pressure on here and still shoot and do what I have to do. It does take a little getting used to with this here. It's not like the clutch where it wraps around your whole entire hand, but this does feel lighter, smaller, and just gives you that extra security of it without slipping off your hands. So again, with this attached and you want to change out your battery, I can still access my memory card. All I had to do is loosen this screw, slide it off. Again, it's flapping. Get to my battery, change it. Once it's back on, slide it back on. And go ahead and just tighten it back up. and there you go. So if you want to install tripod plate, all you have to do is take it off, swap the small screw for the longer screw, slightly thread it in, take the plate. Remember, there is that little notch right there. Line it up with this notch right there. It's on there. Slide it over, and now I can adjust. And now I have an Arca-Swiss tripod plate. Here is an Arca-Swiss small one just for me to show you. And I can just simply slide it on, and there you go, attached to an Arca-Swiss plate with the tripod plate. And this is still, and the micro clutch is still attached. But I don't need it anymore, and I need to take it off. Just go ahead, loosen it, and it's still on and ready to shoot. Here I have the Canon EOS R10. I'm going to use it with the L plate. Take the screw. And as you can see how L plate overlaps the battery door. So if you do need to access the battery door, you'll have to loosen the screw and slide it off. So let's go ahead, take the tool, tighten it down, and the strap fits through the loop with no problems. And depending how tight and how loose you want it, you can set it on whatever number. There you go. So here you go. And with two fingers, it's a little loose, so I can fit three and be able to shoot. I can even do these three fingers and it fits comfortably. If I wanted to go tighter, all I had to do is loosen it and tighten it. So right now this is on the third one. Slot three. So slot three, still a little loose. So here I have it set on four, but on the inside I have it set on nine. You can see 10 peeking out, so nine is on the other side of this. Three finger, it's a little bit tight. Two fingers, I'm able to shift my hands down and take my shots. one finger. So this is with the EOS R10. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So this is the EOS R10 with the micro clutch L plate. So again, if you need to access the battery, you'll have to loosen the screw just enough, slide it, and now you have access to the battery. So let's go ahead, install the L plate onto the EOS R7. So here's the EOS R7. Let's go ahead, install the thumb screw, the tripod. So here I have the EOS R7. So let's go ahead and install the screw. Install the L plate. Set it in place. Tighten it down with this included tool. And if you want, you can go ahead and put it back in. Nice and tucked away. And go ahead and loop the strap. Two fingers. Three fingers. And again, depending how loose or how tight you want it, you can just go ahead and take and loosen it from the strap and on the other side. And to do so, simply take it off. Here, you have the other loop that's tied to it. Take it off, and now you can slide this strap as much as possible. And it goes up to 12. And then once you find your desired number, all you have to do is just lock it in place. Like so, loop it through the strap or the eyelet, and then loop it through one of these holes to whichever setting that you're comfortable with. So let's just say, for instance, do it on a 2. And any excess you can tuck in. So let's go ahead and install the eye plate onto a G7X Mark III. So here's the Canon G7X Mark III. We'll go ahead and use the eye plate on this. So go ahead, and what we'll do first is install the split ring. So it comes with this tool, and if you can tell really close, it's really narrow on this end. So all you do is slide it in, and now you have the opening of the split ring. And all you have to do is insert it, and once it's in, I can just go ahead and just rotate. Until it's in. Now you have the split ring sleeve, so we'll go ahead and install this. Now that the split ring cover is on, you can go ahead and install the screw. Install the eye plate. Go ahead and take off the tool. Once you have it aligned to where you want it, go ahead and tighten down the screw. Go and then install the strap onto the split ring. All you have to do is push it back so that the split ring is exposed. Slide it through and tighten it down. And there you go. So a little loose, but with a little adjustment, I can get it tighter. And this is how it will look. So here I have the strap cinched down even more. And with this excess flap, you can just go ahead and tuck it inside. Like so. And now this is how it looks like on smaller camera and with the eye plate. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. We'll leave a link in the description to where you can purchase these. Hit the bell notification to be notified of when we have new videos. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe. Till next time. See ya.